in terms of like intrinsic value of Pakistan and the Pakistani startup ecosystem, like, do you see any intrinsic value coming out of this particular area or this particular ecosystem as well, or is it just a matter of positioning that there's, you know, this is turf and this is strategically critical in physical and other ways as well, and there's a matter of regional dominance, there's a matter of, you know, the countries around being huge and having huge assets and having huge markets and populations and access to sea. Is it just about that, or are we special?
I mean, unfortunately, it is about that, because we're the junior partner, right? So if the proverbial politics would be Pakistan is the kingmaker in the new global world order, right? So we could be like a smaller party that joins an alliance to make the government, right? So that's why this pivot between the US and China. But intrinsically, I'll talk more about the ecosystem, right? So let's hone into tech now. Why do I feel like this is an extremely undervalued asset? Well, look, we're now talking positive. I mean, I view as Pakistan as very positive. I'm extremely bullish on Pakistan. This is the fifth most populous country on the planet, right? That's a big deal. We're a nuclear power, so security, you know, if we didn't have the nuclear weapons, there's probably a chance that we would have ended up like a lot of the other countries around us, like Iraq or Syria, where transit route countries typically, when powers fight, they do proxy wars, right? So luckily, that ability in our strong security state has protected us to some extent. I'm not, I don't have a dog in the fight, so I don't think in political terms. So I'm just making that clear. I just have to, I'm an investor, so I have to have no emotion, right? So when I look at the country, look, China has to connect via CPEC to Iran for energy security, right? They want energy security from Russia and Iran. Sure. Now, as they enter, they're going to bring investments in. So what is one of the things that they're doing? They're laying out fiber optic, right? So we used to have two internet nodes, the Singapore node and the Dubai node, right? And bandwidth is pretty high and costly in Pakistan. After the new node that's coming, the Chinese node and the peace cable node via Angola, internet connectivity cost is going to drop significantly, right? What that's going to do is make data affordable for everyday people. Now, let's look at our adoption of smartphones. We're the fourth fastest growing country for broadband adoption in the world, with roughly around 750,000 users coming online on a monthly basis, right? How are they coming online? They're coming online via 3G and 4G and through smartphones, because your mass population cannot afford laptops and desktops. They're priced out. That's where the adoption is taking place, right? So now what's happened all of a sudden? Why is this an opportunity? Well, India and the region, Middle East, India, Malaysia, everybody launched 3G and 4G in 2008 and 10. We, because of a regulatory hurdle and delay, actually launched 3G and 4G in 2014 and 15. So as an investor, I would not have invested in Pakistan in 2014 and 15, because my total active market, addressable market for online users was less than 20 million active users, right? Right. Today, that number sits at 80 million. So that's a huge difference. That's critical mass, 80 million, right? It's bigger than a whole countries in Europe, just our online user base. That means that any use case or platform that you that is launched now scales really rapidly. And that's what you're seeing with platforms like BookMe or Mundi Express or Bikeya or Kareem. It's the fifth most populous country. We underestimate ourselves. This is going to be a G20 country by 2030s. I can assure you that. Last parting thought I'll leave you is that our debt to GDP ratio is around 78%. We are a $300 billion economy, roughly, right? I can assure you the informal economy of this country is about another $300 billion, right? Now, what's going to happen is this decade, and you're going to see this with FATF, OECD Common Reporting Standards, and the push for cashless systems, right? This is what we're working on now in terms of these use cases. What Kareem is doing is nothing more than documenting the informal exchange of value between a driver and a ride hailer, right? Same thing, BookMe is doing the same thing in the bus segment, right? Or the travel segment. So what's eventually going to happen is, once payment gateways plug into this, our informal economy is going to leapfrog in documentation. It doesn't matter what the FBR and these guys are trying to do, these tech platforms are going to do it. And so this country is going to leapfrog in GDP growth, not by productivity alone, but by simply the informal economy. 3% of $300 billion black economy does still add 3% to our traditional GDP, right? And no matter what you do in a country like Pakistan, that's a frontier market, the documented economy is still going to roll at about 2.5% to 3%. Even after COVID, we're still basically didn't go down as much as the developed markets, yeah. right? Because we're just a growing country. So don't underestimate Pakistan. Don't lose hope. This is the, you know, this is the bear market right before the extreme bull market. And I get to show you that if you just simply put your effort there, everyone is going to be worth 10x more, even a fruit stand guy in the next 10 years, because the economy grows. That's just a natural phenomenon, right? As long as you work hard and focus on things.